We can look at different parts of what makes a portfolio and look at what they do for our financial health. The three or four asset classes that we normally look at in a portfolio is cash, which is instant energy, and then you look at bonds, and then you look at equity, and you look at real assets like real estate and gold. The role of a good asset allocation in a portfolio is to divide up your money so that you're managing your risk properly and to have the money available when you need it.
You know, I often think what would happen if I put all my money in a particular asset class. Equities, for example. Is it safe to do that? Or is there a way I can smartly allocate my assets and make sure I have the money when I need it? I'm sure you face these thoughts too. So let's ask Monika what asset allocation really means.
Yeah, but you know, I actually just have a little bit of a crib before we start into asset allocation. So there are all these new diet plans. Somebody says you can't eat wheat, somebody says you only eat this, you only drink juice. Now, if I listen to them, then I feel that I can't eat or drink anything. But you know, what I constantly go back to is what my mom used to cook, which was a nice balanced meal.
And
I think we need to look at asset allocation in the same way.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah, so there are so many synergies, you know, between the way we look at food, health, and the way we look at our money, that I'm going to take this analogy and go jump right into asset allocation to say that just as you look at the different parts of the food plate that we have, you know, the sugar gives you instant energy.
Right.
Carbohydrates will give you a little bit of energy to go on with. The proteins will build your muscle long term. Right. So we can look at an asset allocation discussion in a very similar manner. We can look at different parts of what makes a portfolio and look at what they do for our financial health. So what is an asset class? It's a product type which has a certain attribute. Just as sugar has a certain attribute, the three or four asset classes that we normally look at in a portfolio is cash, which is instant energy. And then you look at bonds or fixed income, which gets you a slightly longer duration. And then you look at equity, which, you know, I would give an analogy of protein. It builds long-term muscle. And you look at real assets like real estate and gold. So when we talk about an asset allocation, we talk about how do we allocate our money across these different buckets so that we are able to meet our financial needs.
Asset allocation is the way we break our portfolio into various asset classes, correct?
That's right, absolutely.
So why is it then so important to have our asset allocation right?
Because our financial goals and needs vary. When you need liquidity, when you need cash now, that part of my portfolio is in cash or cash-like products. Like in a mutual fund, you'll call it a liquid fund or an overnight fund. And a part of my portfolio is in debt funds or bonds or fixed income, which gets me to the next 2 to 3 years. You know, these are immediate goals, which are about 2 to 3 years later. And equity really builds financial muscle, which means it's for my longer term. It's a judicious mix of all three, which will take me to my goals. The role of a good asset allocation in a portfolio is to divide up your money so that you're managing your risk properly and to have the money available when you need it. So, and remember, risk comes in two ways. We always think of risk only as in terms of equity risk. But the role of equity in my portfolio is also to deal with the risk of inflation. Inflation is a big risk. The presence of an equity in my asset allocation says that over the long term, my return will beat the risk of inflation eating away my purchasing power. Because remember, different asset classes move different ways over time. So if equity market is going up, you could have the bond market which is going down. You know, you could, and cash is really just preserving the cash value of the money. Don't put all your eggs in one basket. It's asset allocation, which is saying that don't take the risk of putting everything in one place. And even if you watch it very carefully, there could be events beyond your control which make that basket go down.
So does this mean I must allocate my assets in line with my age and goals?
Yeah, absolutely you must. And there's a rough rule of thumb that we use.
Okay.
That we say 100 minus your age is your equity allocation.
Okay.
So if you are 25 years old, then 75% of your allocation is to equity.
Okay.
At age 50, it's half and half. And even at age 75, you still have a quarter of your money, 2500 minus 75,
right,
into equity. So it is closely linked with your age, your allocation.
Okay.
There is one more cut that we need to understand about asset allocation, that when we start with the allocation, we've understood that it is in equity, fixed income,
right,
or bonds,
yeah,
and cash. But when you get into, say, an equity bucket, there is an allocation within that bucket. So you will have maybe half your portfolio in a diversified equity bucket, and you will have part of it in mid and small caps, maybe a multi-cap fund. So you will allocate your money across different pieces of the equity asset class. And once you've chosen, say, half my money is in diversified equity, even then you may diversify across two fund houses,
okay,
if you are doing managed funds.
Right.
Right. So then diversification is really about reducing the overall risk of the portfolio, and you are basically capping your downside risk when you are adding products to a portfolio. But remember, if you add too many, you lose the benefit of diversification.
Okay.
So what happens with mutual funds especially is when people understand it, they go on they overeat. Okay, they binge on funds. So they're starting with saying, no, I don't like funds. And then a year later, they have 50 funds.
Yeah.
Okay, it doesn't help. So if you have 5 diversified equity funds, it's not going to do anything more for your portfolio.
Yeah.
Right? So if your overall needs are capped at about 7 to 10 funds at the most, beyond that, you don't get the benefit of diversification. It sort of tapers off.
This is something I must remember.
Yeah.
So just a quick recap. Cash for my immediate goals, debt instruments like bonds for my short-term goals, and equity for the long-term.
Correct. Absolutely.
Have I got my basics right?
Yes.
Superb. Okay, it's now time for the viewers' question of the week. We have a question from Amit Bedi, who says he's 40 and invests about 1 lakh rupees through SIPs every month. He also has some exposure to PPF. He wants to invest another rupees 50 lakh, but he's not sure if he should do this through portfolio management services or directly invest it in a large cap fund and sit tight. So Monika, what do you think he should do?
Yeah, so what I can tell Amit is that I'm not a big fan of PMS schemes, portfolio management schemes. So let's understand the difference. Mutual funds are like the metro.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody gets in at one place and it, you know, you can choose your station and you can get out.
Mm.
PMS schemes are more bespoke. They're like maybe taking a taxi and saying that I'm choosing this and I want to go there. So it's a little more customized. But when you get that customization, you lose out on the regulatory framework that we have for mutual funds, which give very clear directions on benchmarks, on disclosures, and how you measure the returns that you've got.
Right.
So my problem with getting into or telling somebody to go into a PMS is that I don't know how to evaluate PMS schemes.
Okay.
So they will give you a return projection, or they will show you returns. But a lot of times, I'm not sure really what their benchmarks are and how well they have done, how they have cost. There are enough mutual funds to choose from, and you can do reasonably well if you go with your choice of managed funds, or again, if you can't choose that fund, you can go with an index fund or an ETF. I think that's a far safer route than to try and choose a PMS. So Amit would just do well to choose across the products, take the metro rather than trying to choose which cab to take.
Yes. Yeah. So Amit, I hope you've got your answer. It's now time to wrap up today's episode of Money with Monika. If you have any further queries, write to us at moneywithmonika@livemint.com, or you could also tweet @livemint. Thanks for watching.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.